In this video, I'm going to show you how you could turn a picture into a drawing using a drawing effect in Photoshop. This is the image I'm going to use to turn into a drawing, and I got this other image that I'm going to use as a texture. You don't have to do this step, but I'll show you this at the end. So the first step is we want to duplicate this background. So we could drag it down to our layer on the bottom and make a second layer. And once we have our second layer, we want to desaturate this to black and white. So go up here to Image, Adjustments, and Desaturate. And that's going to turn the image into black and white for us. And now the next step is we want to duplicate this one more time. There is a shortcut Command J or Control J on a PC that lets you duplicate a layer. Now we have a new layer here. Now with this new layer, we want to invert this layer, and that's Command I or Control I on a PC. And now we want to change the blend mode in this inverted layer. So go to this drop down and select Color Dodge. And you should see this white screen now. And once you see that white screen, go ahead and right click on this one and select Convert to Smart Object. Once you convert it, you only have one step left. And having this layer selected, go to Filters, Blur, Gaussian Blur. And that's going to turn it into a drawing. Now you could change the radius to get a different effect. So just play with the radius here. The lower you go, it's going to change the effect. And the higher you go, it's going to turn it more into the image that it was. So I kind of like somewhere around 17, 18. I'm just going to press OK. And now we have the drawing effect. Now at this point, I'm going to add the canvas texture. That's going to create a cool effect here. So I'm just going to grab this background and I'm going to drag it to my selection here. And I'm just going to fit it to the image behind. And it's right here, layer one right on top. Now I just need to change the blending mode. I'm gonna choose multiply this time. And I could change the fill to maybe around 60 and press OK up here. And that's the effect you get. Now you could change the fill to whatever you like. Even at 100%, it didn't look bad, but I kind of like it around 60. Now let me show you what it looked like before. This is your before and this is your after. I hope you found this tutorial helpful. Please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for a lot more Photoshop tutorial and a lot more. Thanks for watching.